marketeers to focus on that ultimately is that the election will be determined, and as you can see from the debate last night, the issues are the same and the polls aren't really shifting. So market remains convinced the election will be determined. Stimulus from there will follow. I think that remains the narrative in the market. But we have to keep a good eye out on Europe, where, of course, the lockdowns are now partial. You know, if that does become a bigger lockdown, then that could maybe change the sentiment in the market. I think for now, this is still a very upbeat market. It's a market where the market is looking at specific data that comes in stronger. And it's including, for example, now today in Europe, as your colleague highlight, there's momentum there in the car market, for example. That does matter, the data. So as earnings comes through and stimulus is anticipated, I don't see the market trading too much off at this point.
Yeah, you know, in America, we always had, you know, bad economic news for a decade was sort of, quote, good news because it meant the Fed was more in play, right? If the economy slowed down, the Federal Reserve reached into its quiver, you know, fire that sort of fiscal stimulus arrow at the market. I think health data has become kind of the same way, Ben, where, you know, if you've got data that's not trending in the right direction, it just increases the odds of more fiscal and monetary support, which bizarrely then would be sort of good. In other words, bad news is also sort of, quote, good. I mean, I hate to say it like that, but you know where I'm going.
Yeah, exactly, Brian. I mean, it's definitely odd in that way, like, you know, a deteriorating health situation, as in an expanding pandemic, if you will, is rather ominous, right? And it definitely, the impact that it has on people and on sentiment and confidence is not positive, yet markets are positive because the health concerns are so high that politicians will focus on, we need to do more and more for the economy to keep it going, and we need to invest into the health crisis itself. I think that too plays a role here. You know, more investment into technology to control the virus is something that I think comes along with this rally as we go from here. And then, of course, the health crisis has changed the economy, and to some degree also perhaps better in the sense of more digital demand, more efficiencies, more demand for other types of services. That too lifts markets. So oddly enough, worsening health crisis leads to stronger markets.
Yeah, and unfortunately, everything has become politicized, even lockdowns. And now, oh, you want to lock down because you want bigger stimulus. I mean, everything has become politicized. Outside of that, Ben, are you seeing value anywhere in the stock markets globally? And if so, where?
I remain optimistic on the reopening, Brian. I do think that we're going to continue to have stages here where the virus comes back as the economy reopens and gets more traction. There will be countermeasures taken, but every time that's the case, the economy actually emerges again stronger. You know, take the example of our own case in June, July, where we had a lot of cases in the Sunbelt states and people were worried. But from there in July and August, the economy actually reaccelerated. So I think the case could also be here in Europe, for example. So I think the European value and reopening trade, as we call it, right, which are, you know, a lot of the airlines, including some of the financials, that's, I think, attractive. Because Europe will see further recovery in the future. And again, stimulus comes online. The same is in the U.S. The leisure hospitality sector continues to lag. The technology sector, that gap will remain. But I think there's the value, particularly in 2021, when all the vaccines globally come together. Call it the 2021 vaccine flood. And I think that's really going to be the drive for the reopening trade.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.